most CPAs seem to misunderstand about succession and mergers and acquisitions?
I think when most people think about succession planning, they think you have to be old. Or they think you are retiring. And actually, succession planning should start from the very beginning. You know, in my own practice, when I ended up having to think about it, I wasn't prepared because I had gotten sick. And I didn't have a plan for how's my practice going to stay open and thriving if I'm not able to run it from a day-to-day basis. That's why this is so important. And so I had to quickly kick into gear and figure out how to keep that business open when I couldn't be there day-to-day. Technology today helps us to be able to create a practice that doesn't rely on us solely. It allows us to have the technology to work from anywhere that we are. But it's really important to think about what goals you want out of your practice. So, do you want to be acquired one day? Do you want to sell your practice one day? You don't know what kind of career changes you're going to have. So for me, you know, there was a certain point in my practice where I determined that I wanted to pivot my career and move into the technology software side of the accounting industry. In order to do that, my business had to be ready to sell. And when I sold, I was young. Like, this wasn't when I was 60 and wanting to retire and so forth. But the business had to prove on its own that it could survive without me, that there was something to sell. And so when you think about building your business and your practice, you need to think of it like a product, like a company, and not your right arm. And so that it is valuable to somebody else in order either to take it over one day or to sell it.